Dog! I just need to know what you need from me.
Wheel chalk.
God damn it! Oh, Douglas.
So I thought about doing it for a while. I don't know. Whole vlog thing. I think it's pretentious and stupid, but I'm vain. I like looking at myself in video, and people think I should do it. And I'm driving a U-Haul truck 3 hours back and forth from Pennsylvania to Connecticut. Some boards fuck. So I guess we'll give this a shot and see what happens. So I'm moving to Pennsylvania, clearly. Why am I moving to Pennsylvania? Well, for starters, Wawa sponsored me. I enlisted in Penn State to figure out the origin of the word John. I'm closing down the shop to become Amish. I wanted to live somewhere where most people drive cars and don't have licenses, or don't have cars and have licenses. That boosted chick hired me as her back sweat swabber. I wanted to suffer every time I go to the diner because nobody knows what disco fries are. I'm not actually moving, and I just want another excuse to rent a U-Haul because I'm blacklisted. I actually moved to Pennsylvania to be closer to Sammy Speed. More letters to spell Pennsylvania than Connecticut, so therefore it's a better state. I'm closing down the shop to become a professional vapor. I'm becoming a cheesesteak. So anyways, today is day two of the move. Heading back to Connecticut now. And I figured, you know what? It's really fucking bored and I've been getting sleepy while driving. So we're going to give vlogging a shot. So I can stay awake, not get a ticket. Or get a ticket. That'd be a good first vlog. First vlog, ticketed while driving. In U-Haul that I'm blacklisted from renting. That'd be a good start. So you moved about 75% of the stuff I'll call it yesterday out of the shop. Hot lapping, this terrible fucking 3 hour drive. Cars are still there. The new shop's jam packed full of garbage and fucking stuff. I'll get video of that later tonight in the dark, because there's no power in the new shop yet. Yeah! It's a cool little spot. I'll show you guys that later. It's a little smaller than a previous shop. It's drastically cheaper. Part of the move out here is I wanted to murder my overhead. And I've successfully done that with this place. It's chill. It's on a main road. It's very nice. We got a lot of painting to do, a lot of cleanup. The prior tenants were actually crackheads. And they sold cars. They sold European cars, mostly Audis, and they got evicted recently, which is probably why I got into my lease so quickly. Just randomly called this place, and it was available and ready to go. Minus that the power was off because they were leeching it off of the neighbors and paying their mechanics in literal crack. So that's cool. Joe Rogan, I smoke cracks! So I don't know how often I'm going to do this. I guess I'll try to do a weekly thing. I don't know if I'm going to have the time for that. Definitely not off the rip. This 3 hour drive is plenty of time to fuck around and talk into my phone and do fucking nothing. So I don't know. This is the boring fucking part of the video. I'm just driving back to Connecticut. I'll show you guys what's left. Just in lunch. It looks like shit. There's all the rubber left over from the bro down.
I mean, my brother's probably going to clean this up tomorrow. That's going to annoy me. Yeah. This is a thank you for the lease.
Thank you. Come again. Thank you
for, I really want to leave that for my old landlord because I fucking hate them. 10 days ago, they started the shit where they're trying to tow out all of our cars.
In half a mile, keep left to stay on I-287 North.
Shut up, Google. Damn! But yeah, I'm going to show you guys the old shop, the new shop, the current state. The 2J piece of shit will be dusty and in some of the video, doing nothing. I don't fucking care about it. New project, EV 3695 giant piece of shit. We're gonna fix a lot of stuff that's wrong with it. There's a ton of shit wrong with it. We're gonna get rid of the spray foam fucking over fenders and shit. We're gonna beat the fuck out of that a lot, so that'll be a good time. We can do a bunch of that. The non-running Civic is still not running, still coming, still waiting for an engine. If you or any of your buddies have one of those magical $300 fucking GSR engines, fucking my boy's got one, fucking LSD tranny. Yeah, if anybody's got one of those, since I'm making a YouTube channel, fucking hook me up with one of those, and I'll fix the Civic, and we'll go beat the fuck out of it, and I'm gonna do an eBay fucking track build, eBay drag strip track build, bro, on the fucking Civic, because I already put enough money in that piece of shit Subaru, and we're gonna do that too, over time this year, as well. So the E36 is gonna get LS swapped, occasionally, someday, eventually, maybe, when I come across stuff. I'm gonna try to make the RS a little prettier by the time we get down to H2O this year. Hey, it's my reflection. It's my reflection. Suck at you all. Yeah, the RS, all it really needs, it's got some bugs that it needs to be taken care of. Like, I have to get the $149,000 removed from the trunk somehow. It's gonna need a little bit more wiring. The cross members and all the raw metal need to get prettied up this year. I'm not gonna do anything crazy with it this year. I really don't give a fuck anymore. It does burnouts and shoots fireballs. Just like to specify for all the fucking e-people out there who know everything about what a car is and how it's built and whatever. The 2J turd was built over excessively to do burnouts and shoot fireballs. Do more in the future? Absolutely. When I feel like actually working on it, because I don't feel like working on it. I don't feel like putting any more fucking money into it. Every time I do, it's too much, and it does the job. It does exactly what it was fucking destined to do. So, you guys can see that at H2O. Like every fucking other year, we go and do burnouts and shit. So anyways, today is Sunday? Sunday, I think it's Sunday. Sunday sounds good. We had the last bro down over the weekend. The last bro down in Connecticut. The new shop really isn't equipped for that. I've got some very nice elderly black ladies that live in front of the shop. I'm not trying to be too much of a dick. And there's not that much parking space, so we really can't bro down too much anymore. But I always thought about trying to host an event, which I don't know. Don't hold your fucking breaths. The last bro down happened on Friday. I'm gonna try to collect as much footage as I can. It was a good time. We did shop burnouts. Things got pretty ridiculous. I'll probably chop those in right about here. I'll show you how much of a shambles it is, what it used to be, or is currently, which is a giant shitball storing four cars and a bunch of shit I haven't moved yet. a lot of used tires.
In 2 miles, use the right two lanes to take the I-87 South, I-287 exit toward Tappan Zee Bridge, New York City.
Okay. So now, a sweet FG is driving me on the highway, and I'm in a 26-foot box truck chasing down an RX-7 because it sounds like it still has a rotary, and I want to see it. It squatted. No, it's actually kind of cool. There's no, I'm just fucking, no, it's over here on the other side of the truck. Go, move, tractor trailer. Hold on. No, we're going to miss it. No, where'd he go? Oh, there he is. Ooh. It's true, I have no life, and I'm very bored. So, I don't know, you guys can tell me what kind of shit you want to see, what you want. If you give a fuck about my day-to-day, which I don't know why the fuck you would. I'm assuming you want to see car stuff. Trolling thing, because I had a couple ideas for other videos. It's not going to be all vlog shit I do. Because that's fucking gay. I thought that said anal. There's a lot of really awful YouTube channels that get a ton of views. I want that YouTube money. So, shit, you tell me what the fuck you want me to do. You want, help me help you. Let me know what I can do for you. Oh, and when suicide bombers drive Mustangs. So I'm finally back at the old shop. There's not much left of anything in here. And I'm realizing that I fucked up royally. I took the ladder and all of our stools. All of our banners are still up. And there's a whole bunch of shit up there. So it's going to be a long night. Picked up this piece of trash from one of my friends. I'm just going to beat the fuck out of it. Slide it, whatever. Who knows? Who cares? It barely runs. It's got a sweet speed hole. And, yeah. I really wish there was some way I could tell this guy how awful his car sounds. I don't know the words to this song. 5 a.m. Fucking kill me, please. I don't wanna be in this truck. None of that rhyme. Why is it so fucking dark? I wanna talk more. This video's gonna be lit. So it's been about a week since the last time I recorded. We're in the shop, the UL truck's gone. We got a couple of the cars down, we're almost done. And this is, this is the new shop. It's 10 pounds of shit in a 1 pound bag is a light way of putting it. It's a little smaller than the last one, but it's fucking cheap, it's quiet, and it's on a main road. So it's gonna do pretty good, I think. So as far as I've been told, I believe the last tenants were crackheads. Actual crackheads and got evicted. So apparently I started off with the electrics being stolen off the neighbors, so it's off, so I have to fix that. And I have to paint, which is fine. I'm gonna do that. So that and I guess my garage door openers don't really work too well right now. Because the crackhead stole the remote, so I have to do that and keep everything locked. So that's good. So there will probably be maybe some crackheads coming by at some point. Did, however, this time, unlike the last shop, doing it by hand, got myself this Betty Crocker Easy Bake Oven looking ass paint sprayer. So I'm sure that's going to work like a bag of dicks. And we'll see. But I don't know. I guess we'll deem this the official before and see how long the after takes. a nice two-car two-bay, well, close two-bay. Smaller than the last one. The ad was listed as 30 by 30, but apparently, or 30 squared. But what he meant was 30 square, as in 30 by 30. So I'm not sure how close he was to that. He's kind of an old-timey, gimpy guy, OG, cash. So I don't know how fuck you were gonna be able to get here. There's some older ladies living in front. They seem nice. They think my name is James. I've corrected them. They still think my name is James, so that's fun. I don't know who's on the other side. Here's the old lady's James house. We'll see. There's also a really creepy fucking house behind, and I don't want to go back there. I'll show you. It's fucking ghosts and crackheads living behind the shop. So that's the ghost crackhead house. This is just gonna be our car parking storage for all the bullshit. But yeah, I'm not fucking going back there ever. Gonna go on a limb right now and guess that this steam cleaning looking motherfucker is gonna spray like a bag of dicks. I'm gonna get there and then throw it outside. And I'm going to be making a new batch of hoodies and shit, I think, soon. So if anybody wants those, because how about y'all? Mine's all fucked up. I'm gonna be doing those, so maybe by the next time I do one of these gay things, I'll have some hoodies up and a link, maybe a Big Cartel again. I'm not gonna stock up on them like last time. I'm gonna do all the shirt orders, made to order, well, pre-buys, and we'll do that again. I'm also gonna call it right now that I'm not gonna clean this thing after spraying the wall, and it's gonna get clogged, and I'm gonna be angry. And they gave you this to clean out the inside of your dick. Some fucked up form of irony, being that the power is off. My new landlord has me stealing power from the neighbors. So, what the fuck? Yeah. Yeah. Thanks. Also, in an attempt to make more space on my phone, I've now realized that the porn folder is missing on my phone. Okay.
Motherfucker.